Dear students, today we will discuss about photoreduction of carbonyl compounds. Photoreduction of carbonyl compounds is a very important phenomena wherein the diaryl ketones, they do not undergo dissociation reactions as we have seen in case of aryl alkyl ketones or diaryl alkyl ketones, which undergo either beta cleavage reactions or Norrish type 1 reactions or Norrish type 2 reactions. But in case of diaryl ketones, because the cleavage of phenyl and other aryl radical is not a very favorable process, and because of that the diaryl ketones they do not undergo photodissociation reactions. Instead they can undergo reduction reactions if there is a provision of compounds which can donate a hydrogen atom. So therefore, the most common example for this type of photoreduction is in case of benzophenone, which is diphenyl ketone. When this is photochemically reacted in the presence of isopropyl alcohol, which act as a hydrogen donating reagent for this ketone, this diaryl ketones undergo photoreduction to produce a molecule of benzpinacol. So two molecules of benzophenone they are converted into one molecule of benzpinacol, whereas this isopropyl alcohol is oxidized to acetone. So this process of conversion of diaryl ketones into 1,2-glycols is known as photoreduction of carbonyl compounds. As far as mechanism of this reaction is concerned, we know the benzophenone or any diaryl ketone for that matter, when this is present in the ground state, we say S0 state. And when we irradiate it in presence of UV light, then through n pi star transitions, this goes to the higher state, that is first excited state, S1 state. And through intersystem crossing, this S1 state can be converted into a triplet state. And this T1 triplet state, which is an excited state, then interacts with the isopropyl alcohol, which is present as a solvent in this case, and a radical of this type is created. So this radical, if you see, this is in resonance with the two aromatic rings which are present in the molecule, and because of this, this radical is highly stabilized. Similarly, by removing this H radical from here, this H radical has been shifted to the ketone to give us this radical. Then isopropyl free radical is also formed during the reaction, and the reaction is energetically favored for combination of these two radicals because they are more stable in comparison to this free radical which is formed. These radicals, they are more stable, as I have told you, because of the greater delocalization of the odd electron present in this radical in comparison to this 2-hydroxy-2-propyl radical. And then two molecules of excited state, T1 state of benzophenone, they will react with one molecule of isopropyl alcohol, and we will get this type of free radical first, and then this will react with another free radical, from where this H radical will be shifted to this place. This will become isopropyl alcohol again, and this will be converted into an acetone molecule. Whereas these two free radicals, they will combine to give us a molecule of benzpinacol. So this is how the benzophenone is converted into benzpinacol through photoreduction of these types of diaryl ketones. Now, to exactly know the mechanism that how these singlet state and triplet states they are formed, we know that in case of ketones, the bond lengths they being longer in the excited state of molecules, and in the excited state the molecular shape also is transformed so as to have minimum interaction between the electrons present in the molecule as per the Frank Condon principle. For example, if we take the case of methanol, in the ground singlet state this is the p electrons present, and this is the non bonding electron present in the oxygen molecule, and these are in the singlet state, and when this singlet state is radiated with UV light, as I have told you that this is converted into the first excited singlet state, that through n pi star transition. And there what happens is that this, if this CO bond length also changes, and bond angle also changes by 25 degree, and these are out of plane angles. This will go in this direction, and this, if we compare with the plane of the molecule in the ground state, then this comes out to be 25 degree. And if we see that in case of ground state, the bond length is 1.21 angstrom unit, but when it gets excited to the first singlet state, the bond length becomes 1.32 angstrom units. So basically, in the excited states, the bond length becomes longer, and this bond angle also changes. And this change in bond angle gives less interaction between these electronic states. Hence, the molecule becomes more stable. And when this singlet state changes into the triplet state, that is first excited triplet state, then the bond length almost remains same, that is 1.32 angstrom units, but the bond angle further increases to 35 degree out of plane angle, and this spin of the electron also changes from singlet to the triplet spin. So that is how the changes in different states of the carbonyl compound takes place, which lead to the formation of different types of photoreduction products. Now, as you have seen in the previous slides, that secondary alcohols, they generally donate hydrogen atoms, and they act as hydrogen donors. But in addition to these secondary alcohols, tertiamines and alkenes, they can also act as hydrogen donors. For example, if trialkylamine is taken, this will interact with the diaryl ketone in the first excited triplet state, and this two electrons, two unshared pair of electrons from the tertiary amines, they will be shared with the triplet state of this diaryl ketone, and we will get this type of free radical anion is formed. And this free radical anion will interact with another free radical anion of the same type, and we will get this type of dianion, and then two protons, they will be taken up by this dianion to get converted into the final product, that is benzphenacol. So this is how in presence of tertiary amines also we can get the photoreduction products of diaryl ketone. Similarly, alkenes, they can also act as hydrogen donors. For example, this can react with acetone at 313 nanometer lambda max, and this at this lambda max value, when this is radiated with UV light, then this will be converted into this type of 2-hydroxy 2-propyl free radical, and then H is transferred from this alkene to the acetone molecule, and this will form another free radical. And then different types of products, they can be formed based on the stability of these two radicals, because this allylic free radical is more stable in comparison to this isopropyl free radical. Then two free radicals of this type, they can combine to give us these types of bicyclic cyclohexene 2-enyl products, or one molecule of this isopropyl free radical and one molecule of this cyclohexylene free radical, they can combine to give us these types of alcohols as the product. 2-cyclohex-2-ene-1-yl-propane-2-ol is formed, or this can withdraw one more H radical from here, and we can get isopropyl alcohol as the product. So by acting as hydrogen donor, these alkenes can give us different types of photoreduction products in case of dialkyl ketones also. So these are the references which have been used for preparing this reaction. Thank you very much.